Hey everybody, what's going on? This is Brendan from Dime Dropping NFL Productions, and today I'm bringing you my top 5 sleeper picks in this year's fantasy football draft. If you have any other sleepers that I have not included on this list, comment it and just let me know, because people will probably be coming here for their fantasy football draft and you can help them out big time. So please hit that like button and subscribe, and let's get into it. At number 5, we have Ryan Tannehill. Yeah, a lot of people think that it's going to be all Derrick Henry this year, but they're also going to have to throw the ball, because if they run it every play, the defense will already know what's up. So Ryan Tannehill is a starter, which is always good to have as a quarterback. If you don't have a starting quarterback on your team, I don't know what you're doing. But Ryan Tannehill is a consistent QB that will get you a decent amount of points every week. That's why he's a later pick, though. He's not going to get you Lamar Jackson points, but he might. He has the potential to every week when he goes out there. But he'll put up consistently good numbers for you. At number 4, we have Noah Fant. Noah Fant is going to be a great safety valve for Drew Lock. Drew Lock can't just throw it down to Jerry Jeudy and Courtland Sutton every play, because that's what teams are going to be looking to guard. Noah Fant will always have that underneath route. Will get you a point per reception. If you do those leagues, it'll rack up those points off those 5-yard gains, and he's going to break one. And when they're in the red zone, he's probably going to be their number one target. So he's a great pick in a later round, because he's not a well-known player, so a lot of people won't be going for him right away. You can get him in probably, I don't know, late rounds, though. And he's always a good player to have, even at your starting tight end spot. If you want to wait on a tight end, get more receivers and running backs, this is the guy you wait for. At the number 3 spot, we have Matt Stafford. Matt Stafford is a very good quarterback, which really surprises me that he drops late in rounds. He gets injured, so that really kills his fantasy points. But when he's on the field, he's absolutely gross. He has a nasty core of weapons. He has DeAndre Swift in the backfield. He has Kerryon Johnson in the backfield. Also, he has TJ Hawkinson, Kenny Golladay, Marvin Jones Jr., the most underrated receiving core in the league. He will be set, trust me, this year. Matt Stafford will have his year like Matt Ryan had his year in 2016. Trust me, guys, on this. He will be great this year. At the number 2 spot, we have TJ Hawkinson. He is very similar to the situation that Noah Fant isn't. Really good receivers. A good quarterback. He's a better quarterback than Noah Fant that we know of right now. But he has more running backs in the backfield than the Broncos do. Actually, no, that's not true. They have Melvin Gordon, my bad. Yeah, it's going to be the same deal. He'll be the safety valve. But he's really talented. He's a really talented guy. And he'll be getting the ball a lot, probably. Because, again, Golladay and Marvin Jones are going to get locked. They're going to have to put 2 people on at least one of them. And that will leave Hawkinson wide open to get the ball in the end zone whenever. Points per reception is going to be really good for this guy. Trust me, again. And the number 1 sleeper you're going to want on my list this year is indeed Anthony Miller. Anthony Miller is an absolute beast. The reason why he's number 1 is because he's going to slip to a really late round, and he's going to get the ball a lot this season. With an unsure QBs, that's going to kill him a little bit. But they're going to want to prove something. Mitch Trubisky has to prove a lot this year to even keep his career alive, which means he's going to have to trust his receivers. And Anthony Miller is the guy they're going to have to trust. Allen Robinson's going to get crazy covered because he's Allen Robinson. You saw him in Jacksonville. Now, Anthony Miller is going to be left open. Points per game, per reception, my bad, is going to be high. Points per game also is going to be crazy. So trust me, this guy is super athletic, and he will be a beast.